scary stuff, Sonny. What is it? What is that big scary stuff? That old dead stump has been there for years.
I thought it was going to be really easy.
Well, that first part was easy right there.
Hey you guys, welcome back to the channel. So today, well actually yesterday, we just got done getting the rest of this hay off this hay field. And this used to be tiled. And the tile has actually collapsed. And now we have these big sinkholes. Come here, bud.
I'll show you how big.
Look how deep those are. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to retile the hay field. Is that crazy? And we got corrugated pipe over here, and we bought the stuff that has the sleeve on it, and the sleeve will help filter out the dirt so it doesn't plug or tile. And we'll go over and show you what we got. All right, so here's our corrugated pipe. You guys, you can see it has little slices in it, and that allows the water to come down inside, and the sleeve here will go around it, and that'll help filter the topsoil and that kind of stuff to plug in our pipe up, so hopefully it'll last a lot longer. And we're gonna dig this trench all the way up. I originally bought 1,000 feet of it, and I'm thinking, or not 1,000 feet, but 1,000 or 100 yards of it. But I'm thinking it's about 150 yards. So we'll probably have to go back in and buy another section. But this will get us started, and we're gonna start digging. So here we go. So when I was making hay here, I ended up just raking all the loose stuff right on top of those holes and just bypass that area. And it actually made digging extremely difficult because I actually had to move the hay before I could get down in there. My youngest son, he just loves being on the equipment. I mean, just yesterday he spent 10 hours on the tractor with me and he was all ready to go on the excavator. Pretty cool. Super great on this excavator. I only have probably about 15 hours of runtime total on an excavator. And I was having issues here because the ground was so wet, I kept plugging up my bucket, my dig bucket. So I kept having to like bang it around, get the dirt out, and just keep working away at it. But I got better and better as I went. You can see in these videos, especially right here, my little blades coming down, I kind of pick up the front end. That really stabilizes that excavator when you're digging. You don't get so much rocking inside the cab. And so that's why I'm gonna back up, drop that blade down, get a little bit of weight on the front end, and I start on digging again.
Get hot. Sweet. Two more to go.
So believe it or not, I've only been digging here for about 30 minutes on the excavator. And I'm about 100 and, I think it's about 160 feet so far.
I'm cutting the track.
This is like all brand new for daddy.
I don't know.
All right, so this is a brand new thing. I've never done this ever. So I hope we're doing it right.
I watched a ton of
YouTube videos on it.
All right, let's see here.
So right where I'm at standing, you guys, I'm actually shoving that pipe about 2 feet under the road into another pipe. So that way it'll hold it, and then I can start burying this. Here, bud, help me.
You can come back to cutting that if you... It's a python! Don't let it eat you!
So when you put this stuff in, you want to go deep enough. You know, I'm trying to go 18 inches, almost 24 inches down, because if I ever plow this field and rework it, I don't want to tear up my drainage pipe. So you got to keep that in mind when you're putting this in. All right, stud. And I think we totally botched unrolling this.
It looks a little tangled.
Yeah. Let's see here. Yeah, I think we pretty much... Let's go this way.
And a giant tangle.
Okay. All right, now take that, Michael, and start walking with it. And I'll go straight up out of the field, so right up there. Keep going.
Follow the ditch.
Keep going. There we go, got that out. Keep going. Kind of looks like a python.
I said that a few minutes ago when you were wrapped up in it. I said, it's a python, don't let it eat you.
Hey, hold up, Michael, let me...
Oh, it's going up there pretty far.
There we go. Keep pulling. When you throw it in the hole.
All right, should we help you get it in here?
Yeah. 100 feet went a lot further than I thought it would.
Yeah, not bad.
So here's our connections where we're gonna union up the two hoses together. There we go.
All right.
We're clipped in.
You just need the next one.
Okay. There you go. And then I'll pull it out. Okay. Now get that boiler out there so you can see what's going on. Michael here just turned 8, three days ago. And man, he's really been helping out a lot on the farm. We had him up on the tree or the hay baler this year. I'm hoping that by next year he'll be able to cut hay for me. But he's been really growing and becoming a really big help. Comes a flip. Kind of tricky to unroll.
Yeah. I was like, I can't even do this job.
It's long.
Keep going. Here we go. Flip. Okay.
All right. See how far you can go.
Seems like such a flimsy connection.
I know. No,
they don't pull apart very easy, huh. So that's good, I guess.
Hi, doggy. Is that a good seat? big hole.
In the last couple of years, that erosion has gotten really bad. It could almost swallow up, you know, that excavator. They're so big. So it was definitely time to retrench this and put in a drain pipe. And I'm going to actually have to haul dirt in because the holes were so big, and then try to fill in those big holes on top of the pipe. This hole was actually so deep it actually got me high centered. I swung the arm around the boom and I have to push down to get me up and out of this hole. These excavators, man, they're so versatile and you can do a lot with them. Glad I have it.
Pull the hose here. Oh.
Okay, so I'm actually using the tractor here. I'm burying my pipe. After I did this project, I actually wish that I would have rented a ditch digger and not dug such a big, massive hole. I think it would have been better and easier. And instead of having these big clumps of sod, oh, and I left all that hay in there too. It turned out to be a pain in my butt. So next time I would have done not, I would have gotten all that loose hay out of, and then I would have rented a ditch digger so you have nice sod putting back on your pipe instead of these big clumps of dirt that I dug out. I think that would have made a lot better job. It would have been a lot cleaner. I ended up digging that out in like less than an hour. I spent 2.5 hours burying this pipe, and I had to go dig up fresh dirt and abandon this, which I didn't show in the video, and fill that all up with nice fresh dirt out of the garden. And then I came back through and I still have big clumps of sod everywhere. So wasn't the prettiest finish. So actually hopefully learn from my mistakes. See all that grass I just slopped on there? I ended up having to get off, pulled all that out. So anyways, but I got it in. Just took me a little bit longer than I was expecting, and I was already tired from doing hay, so I was glad this project was done. There you can see again, look at all that hay. What a mess I made. So anyways, I hope that helps you guys out. If you guys ever try to tile your field, I would definitely rent a ditch digger. I really like that corrugated pipe with the sleeve on it. I think that's gonna do a great job. Make sure you have a nice, clean surface to work before you start digging. It'll save you a lot of work. So now you can see I'm hauling in fresh dirt and dumping that all in the cracks. And over here, after I get these big piles and I'm coming through with the front end loader and I'm trying to fill that hole that I dug, and I'm end up picking up big chunks of sod and hauling out of the field. Here's another big wad I'm doing. And after that, it actually went pretty good, so.
What kind of load is that? When you